Hello, and welcome to this tutorial overview of some of the essential elements to get you started editing content in Blackboard Learn. You will be able to use the information in this tutorial to edit content in your global campus course space, if you choose. Or you can continue to communicate your changes through course verification. Today you will get an overview of aspects of your online course space, including how to toggle between edit modes in Blackboard, how to preview the class as a student user, an overview of the robust Blackboard Learn content editor, a discussion of copyright considerations, and links to resources to ensure that your class is ADA compliant. When you open your Blackboard class, you will land on your home page. Depending on how you left the class the last time, edit mode may be on or off. When edit mode is on, you will see a green button in the upper right side of your screen. When edit mode is off, you can get a better idea of what formatting looks like and check that changes you made to your course space look correct. You can also go into what is called student preview. In that mode, you can actually interact in your course as if you were a student. Student preview is helpful to check that your material is being presented in the manner that you want your students to access it. On the left panel, you will see the main navigation menu. The menu will adhere to the Global Campus template. We recommend that you use this structure as much as possible, since a uniform template makes it easier for students to consistently locate important elements of each course in which they are enrolled. When you are ready to edit what is on the page, you will use what is called the Content Editor. The Content Editor in Blackboard provides a lot of options. If you are not seeing three rows in your Content Editor toolbar, use the arrow icon on the right side of the toolbar to expand the options. On the first row, you will find icons and functions that are similar to word processing programs. You can bold, italicize, strike through, change the font, size, color of the font, create bulleted lists, numbered rows, highlight text, and remove formatting. The second row includes options to cut, paste, copy, and search text. If you change something and you want to undo it, then click the backwards arrow. Conversely, if you undo something and then change your mind, you can click the forwards arrow to redo it. There are options for both super and subscript typing. You can highlight text and add links or remove them. There's also a spell check function that includes options to check spelling in US English, UK English, or Spanish. The third row of tools provides interesting options to create and add dynamic elements and multimedia to your course. The camera with a red dot in the middle will allow you to record and embed video straight into a page in your course using your web camera on your computer. You will need to have an existing YouTube account, or you will need to create one in order to access this option. Videos you create for your course using this tool will be housed on YouTube. The paperclip icon will allow you to add files from your computer to your course space. There will be an option to attach files and images from your computer or from the content collection in Blackboard. The block quote function will allow you to easily quote sources you are incorporating into your text without having to worry about reformatting the text yourself to indicate that you are quoting. The Insert Table Editor will allow you to enter tables into your page and functions much like tables do in Microsoft Word. The HTML and CSS functions will allow you to access advanced options for formatting your page. The F of X button will allow you to launch the Math Editor. The Math Editor has options for common formulas used in mathematical equations. To use the editor, just select the equation format that you desire, and then select each of the green boxes to input numbers, symbols, or letters. The Image button will allow you to upload or link to an image you wish to use in your course. The Appearance tab will allow you to adjust how the image appears on your screen in relationship to the text on the page. The Video button will allow you to embed media you have on your computer. Under Advanced Options, you'll have several options to customize your video, just like you do with images. We recommend that you turn off the autoplay and loop options unless you want the video to play and loop as soon as a user accesses the page you've embedded the video on. The mashup feature is an additional option to add multimedia to your course. It has its own tutorial and you can access it on Blackboard's YouTube page. The great thing about the content editor is that anywhere you can add text, you can use all the functions available in the content editor, even in giving comments in the gradebook. On a final note, please bear in mind that copyright law prohibits uploading copyrighted material without permission into an online course space. We encourage you to exercise caution when using any outside material in your online course for which you are unsure about the copyright status. For more information on copyright and online course material, as well as resources for finding copyright-free material, visit elearning.wsu.edu/online-courses/develop/copyright.aspx. Also, all online courses must be ADA compliant. If you are adding video or audio to your course space, you'll need to address how you'll provide access to students with different abilities. Visit elearning.wsu.edu/online-courses/develop/ada.aspx for more information. If you have any questions on what constitutes copyrighted material, how to make your class ADA compliant, or anything else regarding using Blackboard to teach, please feel free to contact the experts at the WSU Global Campus for more information at global.elearning@wsu.edu.